السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وبعد. Welcome to episode 3 of Truly the Believers Have Succeeded. In today's episode, we're going to take a brief look at verse number 3 from Surah Al-Mu'minun, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the believers as الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, those who are humble in their prayers. So the first quality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to highlight is related to prayer, which highlights the importance of prayer in our daily lives as Muslims. So we're not only supposed to be praying 5 times a day, but we're supposed to be praying with a certain quality. And that quality is described as khashi'una, with humility. So the word khashi'una, it's the plural of the word khashi'un. And it literally means one who has humility. And this humility is created through a sense of fear, a sense of awe and reverence. And then this humility expresses itself in the calmness of a person's limbs. So although khushu' might literally mean humility or submissiveness, when it comes to prayer, it refers to bringing about a perfect state of concentration. So that when a person is thinking, they don't allow any thoughts to enter into their heart except for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So essentially, when we approach prayer, we're supposed to approach prayer with a sense of gratitude, with a sense of thankfulness, of submission, obedience, devotion, and servitude. That we recognize our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are His servants and He is our Lord and Creator. So that when we stand up to pray, we're standing in front of our Lord with a sense of absolute utmost humility. And they say that khushu', it has two aspects to it. The first is external, which refers to the physical form of praying. And the second is more internal. So when it comes to the external aspect of khushu', it means praying according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it means praying properly, observing all of its proper etiquettes. So we should be standing still. We're not moving around. We're not fidgeting and playing with our clothes or our caps or our beards. We're looking down at our place of sajda. Our right hand is on top of our left hand. And we're praying with a sense of calmness. We're not rushing through it. The second aspect, which is internal, which is the spiritual aspect of prayer, is more important. And this is referring to absolute concentration, awareness, and focus in one's prayer. Where we're paying attention to what we're saying, what we're reciting, we're concentrating on its meanings, and we're trying to build this connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, that requires effort, that requires time, that requires energy. But most importantly, it requires to learn what we are reciting in prayer. And that is something that is extremely important for every single one of us if we want to develop khushu' in our salah. We have to know what we're saying in our prayers. So when we start prayer and we say Allahu Akbar, God is the greatest, we should know what that actually means. What is it referring to? What are the possible meanings behind it? When we start prayer with the thana, with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're praising Him with sincerity. It's genuine praise because we feel the sense of gratefulness and thankfulness to Him. When we recite the Fatiha, we recognize that this is a conversation between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they say that there are several ways to develop khushu' and salah, but two of the most effective ways are first and foremost, recognizing who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, learning about our Lord and Creator, learning about Him through the divine names and attributes He Himself mentions in the Qur'an. So learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Al-Khaliq, the Creator of the entire universe and every single thing that it contains, that He is As-Sami', the All-Hearing, Al-Basir, the All-Seeing, He is Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, Al-Hakim, the All-Wise. So learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that it builds that sense of reverence and awe and respect. So it's going to create that sense of humility. And the second most effective way is by learning, again, what we're saying in our prayers. So learning what all of the adhkar in prayer mean. So what does Allahu Akbar mean? What does Subhana Rabbi al-Azim mean? What does Subhana Rabbi al-A'la mean? And learning the meanings of the tashahud and anything else that we might recite in prayer. And if we do this, then we're going to find that prayer becomes something that we enjoy. Prayer is something that brings us happiness and peace and contentment. It's not going to seem like a burden or chore on our shoulders. Rather, it's going to be something that we look forward to. As the Prophet ﷺ told us, جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَةِ, that my peace, my contentment, my happiness has been placed in prayer. So So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all the ability and the opportunity to develop khushu' in our salah, so that salah can also become the coolness and contentment of our eyes. Jazakumullahu khayran, wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.